Are your railway team looking like this? Or have you seen people running team like this? Have you ever wondered why they use so many charge IDs and why people are not running other units? We will talk about why and how charge ID dominates in this company currently. First of all, we need to know what is charge. Charge is a status, well, more of a resource that is used by a certain skill for additional effect. It can be other status, self buffs, or just straight more damage, and at the end of the turn, reduce the count by 1. Corps that use charge are usually Warp Corp, Arc Corp, and Rose Spanner Workshop. I will talk about W Corp and Arc Corp here, and Rose Spanner will hopefully be another video. But charge team were not always good. It has a lousy start back at Season 1, where it was just R Hit, W Foss, W Don, R Ish, and W Mute. Back then, only R Hit and W Don are used, and it's mostly because of their skills that gave fragile, not necessarily because they are a charge unit. R Ish and W Don need too many turns to activate their skill tree. W Foss is mediocre as a charge unit, and don't get me started on W Mute. He is very slow for using his skills, even on skill 2, and Arhit are a charge ID in name only.
What the dog doing?
Project Moon that added Don Quixote Telepole to help units getting their charges, but it is actually their biggest mistake, because now every charge unit will have a lot of charges, and I think it's the reason why they have self-tremor count now. Then Season 2 came along, or I should say, the rise of the charge ID season. Currently, there are 6 charge-related IDs that were released in this season. First 3 were Rose Spanner unit. Rose Spanner basically used charges to deal more tremor or tremor burst. Then, Armure came along. He's pretty good, but like the other charge IDs, he lacks the charge count to use his skill with full potential without losing turns. Then, the unthinkable happened. Uptie 4. Uptie 4 revolutionized charge team. Most of the units that were previously too slow get more charges count so they can do their potential damage much quicker. W Don gets coin power in both skill 1 and skill 2, raising her clash power, and 2 more charges in her skill 1, which is huge. Now, she can use rip space with only 1 rip and 1 leap instead of previously 2 leaps. W Foss got a huge buff as well, 2 more charge count in skill 1, got 3 charge count surplus in skill 2, and more clash power in skill 3 if you have more than 5 charges. Reindeer Ishmael got 2 more charges on both her skill 1 and 2, and the charge requirement to use skill 3 is reduced by 2. This is big considering how slow it was before. The Blimur had a glow up from being too slow to inflict anything, because skill 1 only gave 3 charges. Now it gives 6 charges instead and can do more things at a faster rate. Arhit got yeah. Then they added 2 more units, W Ryoshu and W Honglu. They also bring a new mechanic, Charge Barrier, which is basically the same as a barrier but will refund the unused count as a charge at the end of the turn. W Honglu is more of a quote-unquote tanker or shielder of the charge team, because he can apply charge barrier with his skill. Meanwhile, Ryoshu is pretty similar to W Don, has a debuff status on skill 2 with a huge damage on skill 3, but W Ryoshu have a buff on kill on top of it that give haste on skill 2 and charge barrier on skill 3. With all the charge ID being explained here, let me tell you the pros and cons of the charge IDs. The pros are they have big damage, good debuff, and great synergy with other meta units, mainly because of Don Quixote Teleport. The cons are they need setup to gain charges, and they are not auto-friendly, because you can lose something if you don't have enough charges. In W Don and W Ryoshu's case, they lose HP. But in Reindeer Ishmael case, she targets a random units instead and can zap your allies to death. But the current quote-unquote endgame content, which is Mirror Dungeon 2, Heart, and Refraction Railway 2, have gifts that help charge team to utilize their kit faster. Mirror Dungeon 2 have buffs that can give more charges, more damage, and speed, while Railway have +2 charge count instead of 1 compared to other status, which is huge for some IDs. Noticeably, WRIO and Rendered Ishmael then can use skill 3 at turn 2 with just 1 charge buff. And considering all units have the charge IDs of some sort, and most of them are either the best or one of the best IDs they have, it's quite easy to make a team focusing on charge in Railway 2 because of the buffs. Nearly all abnormalities are beatable with charge team, unlike the other status that can get capped depending on the boss. The only counter to the team is Centipede, but that is if you lose a clash. If you don't, then it is not a problem at all. As of the time of the writing, there are two big teams for the low turn runs. It's pretty obvious that both of these teams are using charge team, with the main difference between both of those teams is the fact that one team abuse sinking more than the other team. But the main core unit is still the same, charged. The reason why this is the case will be explained in the next video detailing about Railway Line 2 in general. But nevertheless, it is painfully obvious that the charged team is really good at the moment in RR. Let's review the cost of charged team again, shall we? Usually, charged team are not auto-friendly. But in the Infected Railway, the whole mode is not auto-friendly. The other cons is usually they need setup to gain charges to use their main skill, not necessarily skill 3. But we have buff to literally gain 2 charges per turn, not 1, and it is stackable. So that's a cross as well. Charge IDs are so good, people are putting W Don, W Ryoshu, and R Hit in their top 5, or even top 3 meta units. And W-Don and R-Hit are in top 3 units at 2 at Season 1. And that is a problem in itself. They are so good that the other IDs are simply not used. And what I fear is the next Don, Heatcliff, or Ryoshu IDs are always gonna be compared to their respective charge ID and make them less appealing to other players. Take an example of Chef Ryoshu. Her skill 3 deals quite a lot of damage. Even there's a strat of one turning, Wayward, and Terminus with Chef Ryoshu. But compared it to the versatility of WRIO, she does not see light in Railway 2. Same with units like Singudon, Sunshower, Heatgrave are disregarded just because they have a better IDs. Project Moon needs something good to deal with this, because I feel like this is clearly a favoritism, not that I don't like it. Sinking have Sinking Deluge, which in my opinion is a mistake. But they are still very good right now due to Rodia Rhymeshank. So hopefully, Project Moon will try to combat charge team with making other status more viable. I guess they tried to make other status viable from Railway 1 because Railway 1 was just unga munga damage. But we still need more variety in our team. I'm not saying like make other status OP like Sinky, but at least make them more viable to use. In this Refracted Railway, for example, we have the trio core of a status. WRIO, WDON, and W or R Mirror for charges, and Trisang, Mora Ishmael, and Rhymes Diechi Rodia for sinking. It will be cool to have more of those trio core of a burn, or poise that we can use on the some bosses because they are better than the other. Unlike this, where we either use charge plus damage or sinking plus damage team. But as I said earlier, they are heading in the right direction. Hopefully, they will make more IDs viable. And that is all for this video. Hope you guys enjoy it, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!